终于都够人。
Members, it's time and we have a quorum. I call to order the meeting. First, the election of chairman and deputy chairman for the panel on information technology and broadcasting. Please note that in accordance with Rule 77.6 of the Rules of Procedure, a member who is the chairman or deputy chairman of government advisory body in respect of matters which a panel considers to be directly related to the terms of reference of the panel shall not be the chairman or deputy chairman of the panel. And also, according to Rule 77.7, which it states that a member shall not be chairman or deputy chairman of more than one panel at the same time. And then in accordance with House Rule 22 and Appendix 4, please make nominations for the chairmanship. It must be made orally and seconded orally. Ms. Claudia Mo nominates Mr. Charles Mock. Any seconder? Mr. Elvin Young seconds the nomination. Mr. Mock, do you accept the nomination? I do. Any other nomination, please? No? I'll count 1, 2, 3. Thank you. Congratulations, Mr. Charles Mock. Please come over to chair the meeting.
Now
we proceed to the election of the deputy chairman. Ms. Lowercott, I nominate Dr. Elizabeth Quad. Any seconder, please? Mr. Tommy Cheung. Dr. Quad, do you accept the nomination? I do. Any other nomination, please? I'll count to three. 1, 2, 3. Fine. Congratulations, Dr. Elizabeth Kwok is elected ipso facto the deputy chairman of the panel on information technology and broadcasting for this session. Item 2 on the agenda. Well, for our panel, is relatively straightforward. It so happens that for our scheduled meetings for the 2017 to 18 session, it doesn't. There are no days that clash with any major events, so there's no need to amend the schedule at all. Members, do you agree? Do we accept the schedule? Fine, thank you. Item 3, items for discussion at the next meeting. I'm sure you have the list of understanding items for discussion, as well as the list of follow-up action. Of course, for the next meeting, first of all, 17th of October, Tuesday, 8:30 a.m., same room here, is the policy address briefing. And then for the regular meeting in November, the administration has proposed two items, 13th of November, 2:30 p.m. A usually is the first one to consider every year. Capital Works Reserve Fund Head 710, Computerization Subhead A007GX Block Allocation. Item 2, Film Development Fund Review. Members, any comments on this? No objection? Well, let's look at other items that members may wish to raise. Mr. Chen. Yesterday, in the policy address, there's a suggestion of EID for Hong Kong citizens. Now, there's also development of Smart City here on the list of outstanding items. I wonder if that's covered. If not, I would suggest that we include EID under the item development of Smart City, because this is an important issue. Mr. Chen, I propose that we take a note of your suggestion, and we'll ask the Innovation Technology Bureau whether this should be included under Smart City, as suggested by you, or whether there's a need to have a joint meeting with the panel on financial affairs. So I will consult the Bureau, and we'll make sure that there's a a chance for us to discuss it. Of course, the policy address was only delivered yesterday. Mrs. Regina Yip, I support Mr. Chen Ying's, but we shouldn't just talk about EID. What about electronic ID of corporates? Because it's necessary for e-commerce. So we will talk to the ITB about that as well. Ms. Xiong. What about games, electronic games? Young people are very much involved. We have competition on electronic games as well. So we'll, if possible, can we have a special meeting? And we can talk to other departments. We don't know yet which department is responsible for that, but please find out. Well, that's a very good point. I understand there are two or three bureaus, one knows which should be responsible for games. Perhaps we could talk to the other panels to see how we can take this up. Next, Ms. Claudia Mo, to be followed by Ms. Ben Chen. In the policy address, there's the latest suggestion of deduction from the Octopus card, and people can get more than $300 of public transport subsidy. I'm not entirely familiar with IT, so I have some questions. First of all, for this sort of arrangement, would it involve massive administrative fees? Can we take it up here? And secondly, would it further, you know, consolidate the monopoly status of Octopus, or dominant status of Octopus? And thirdly, what about privacy? Because maybe it's recorded there where people go from point A to point B. So what about privacy? Now, having heard Ms. Mo, first, about reimbursement or rebate through Octopus card, I think it's probably a matter for the transport panel. Of course, there may be technical issues involved. Maybe I'll talk to the clerk. Perhaps we can write to the administration and ask them. But whether there's a question of administrative fees, I would have, I would believe perhaps it's more appropriate to be taken up in transport panel, because that's about fees. Privacy, yeah, you raised the point of privacy. I know your point, but I'm not sure again if it should be taken up here, or maybe it's the Constitution Affairs panel. In any case, I think probably the lead is the transport panel. Maybe in the policy address briefing at the transport panel, there will be questions about this already. Let's see if the administration is able to answer your questions. Because I see that on the panel transport, there is a much longer list of outstanding items. Well, here we don't have a short list either, as you have expressed concern on many issues. Mr. Ben Chen, I also want to talk about games, electronic games. As Ms. Yong said, somehow it doesn't fall under any particular department of bureau, and the ITB has not included it in their portfolio. So if we're going to talk about it, perhaps, Chairman, please arrange for us to attend some gaming activity, because many don't even know what electronic games are about. Another point, I want to talk about telecom stations. Whenever telecom companies want to build stations, the public raise objection. But who's to make the decision? I would like to have a discussion. And also for the smart lamp posts, that's been good development. Would the government consider putting the telecom stations in the lamppost, so it's not as intrusive to the public? Because the lampposts are closer to populated areas, and that means then it's not no need for high-frequency devices. Okay, for the first issue, we'll talk to the ITB to see who's responsible. and maybe we could before if we have a discussion, we'll see whether we could pay a visit first before the discussion. As for base station, I agree it's a very important subject. I'm sure if there's no objection among members, this is something that falls under this panel. We'll follow up on that. So if members have no objection, we will include it on the list and see when we can schedule a discussion. Next, Mr. Holden Chow. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Item 17 on the list of outstanding items. Internet access service in rural areas. Yesterday in the policy address, there's an announcement that the government will help with the installation of optic cables or optic fiber cables in rural areas. Here, the proposed timing for discussion is to be confirmed, but perhaps in the policy address briefing already, we could have dealt with this item. Since it's already in the policy address, I'm just trying to see if we could speed up discussion this way. Well, I'm sure on Tuesday, everybody will ask a question. Some colleagues may ask about it. Let's see if you'll be happy with the answer. In any case, and if necessary, we can advance this item so we could take it up sooner. Thank you. Next, Dr. Elizabeth Quart. Thank you. I agree for EID or e-corporate ID. These are important urban infrastructure, and it takes time for this for them to wait in the queue, so we should advance those items. For tele gaming is also important. I hope it's the ITB that will take up the issue eventually. On the internet access area service in rural areas, many members have been asking for that from the government. Since the government is going to do it, I think the government should come back and give us more information as soon as possible. If next week they're not able to give us enough details, please try to advance this item, Mr. Chairman. Thank you. Anything else from members?
I only recall at the last session, there are only one or two meetings on which the government's websites are present, which is too few. So when we have ITB and then we have the Commerce and Economic Development Bureau, we all agree that the ultimate use of the time, hope that there will be no item for discussion. We have to make sure that the administration can arrange better. At least there will be two items for discussion each time, or even more. Any other proposal or suggestions? None. We move to the next item, AOB. Any other AOB from members? If not, declare the meeting is now adjourned. Thank you.